We've been looking at offshore pipelines here for many, many years. More recently, they've been starting to think about what happens when a pipeline axially walks. And what that means is that it sort of moves backwards and forwards along its length as the pipeline is turned on and off.
We might make allowances for walking, but sometimes we find that those allowances are insufficient. Shell had an application. They developed in rapid time the pipe clamping mattress solution. The pipe stopped moving. Everyone's very happy with the outcome.
We were aware of the pipe clamp mattress, but we also were aware that there was really very little evidence of how it was performing. So we started a conversation with them to say that we could model that in our centrifuges and show exactly how it's performing.
So the PCM at full scale is sort of, I think of it as just a hinged butterfly type clamp. And we had two actuators really in the centrifuge while spinning at G. So we used one actuator to lower everything down and then a second mini actuator as well to lower the PCM further down.
We test the pipelines, we make them walk. From a design perspective, you don't want them to walk, because when we do that, we can work out and we can measure how much resistance there is to that walking. And it is that resistance number that we would provide that tells them how efficient the solution is.
So I think what industry wanted from us was to see over a long period how their PCMs would work. The great thing about the centrifuge is that we can scale down time. So a one-day test in the centrifuge is actually modeling 2.5 years.
So the main impact of this research has been to really reduce risk and uncertainty in offshore design, but also significant cost savings, because the research tells them exactly how many of these pipe clamp mattresses they would need for a particular project.
And so being more efficient makes it also have a lower environmental impact, a lower footprint.
It was developed by Shell. They want to see it being used, not just by Shell projects, but by operators all over the world.
We started to talk with Shell and said, well, if we do a little bit of physical model testing on maybe some other soils and other types, we could publish that, we could get that out there, it'll increase the industry's awareness. So we then started talking with BP. We offered to do a testing program, and BP, as I understand, have actually now fabricated and installed those mattresses. At about the same time, Woodside also had an application. By bringing them all together, it allows us then to do research at a level which can then, when it goes back to industry, is much more transformative. And not just in Australia, but more broadly, it allows us to look at, you know, exporting some of that technology around the world.